So today was the penultimate round of the FIDEchess.com Grand Swiss, and there were several players who were on 6.5, three of them, and many players on 6 points. On the top board, Alireza Firuja is now completely winning his game against David Howell. And there were some crazy tactics in this game. One of the very beautiful moves that David Howell managed to find in deep time pressure was to play his queen to c6. And you cannot take the queen because of rook e1 checkmate. And that was a very nice tactic by David, but Alireza kept his cool, brought his bishop back, and eventually transposed into this endgame, which was better for him. MVL and Fabiano Caruana drew their game. Oparin won, so he's on 7 points now and has good chances to make it to the candidates. And this is the great thing about Grand Swiss. Certain players who might never get a chance to play in the candidates get it from here. We had Essipenko versus Shashikiran. It was the Sicilian Moscow variation, and both the players decided to, you know, play like no castling chess. Shashikiran put his king on f8 and Essipenko here put his king on d1, and it seemed like Shashikiran was doing fairly well in this position. He had some pressure. Where he went wrong was that in this position he could have gone b4, rook d4, or even just king f8, but he took on e1, and this eased out white's task for fighting for an advantage, because now the main thing is that white is going to play b3, king b2, and his queenside majority is easier to push without the bishop on the board. So this is exactly what happened. Essipenko won a pawn, and then slowly and steadily he has managed to improve his position substantially, and now I have a feeling that this is just over. So this game is still going on, but Essipenko will win this. Shashikiran has been playing really well, and if he wins tomorrow, maybe he can qualify for the top 8 spot for the Grand Prix selection. Harikrishna's game was against Sanan Sujiro, and after roughly equalish position, knight h6 was played by Sanan, sacrificing a piece. Then eventually the game was drawn with a perpetual check. Nihal Sarin against Vladimir Fedosiev. It seemed like white had a small edge, but Nihal, as always, is so solid. He gave his opponent no real chances, and the game ended in a draw. In the final position, could have been that both sides could have played on, but they agreed to a draw here. The game between Alexey Sarana and Raunak Sadhwani. In this position, Raunak actually went wrong by taking on e5, and then after fe5, it seemed like his position was just too passive. White is just building it up, tripling down the f-file, knight coming to c5. I mean, it was quite a smooth game for Sarana, and here queen d5 and e6. Raunak resigned. So not a great game. Arjun Arigasi managed to hold his own against David Navara. I think somewhere it seemed like Arjun had some chances here. Maybe if he had gone a4, he could have been pushing, but he did not. And then eventually black managed to exchange a few pieces. He was exchanged down, but it was not enough. And here players exchanged the queens and agreed to a fighting draw. Well played by both. The game between Pragnananda and Boris Gelfand, in which game is going to end in a draw. But somewhere out of the opening, it seemed like Pragnananda had a very good position. Like here, I think Prag was just pushing here. Take, take, queen takes. And now he played king, queen g3, knight h5. If he had found queen e5, he would have been better. He played queen f3. I mean, he would have been close to winning. But after this, his advantage kind of withered away. And here, actually, if Gelfand had found queen a8, then he would have won the game. He's clearly better with two pieces for a rook. But Boris went knight d7. And after rook e8, now the rook is pursuing the queen, and they will most likely agree to a draw. Haik Marty Rossian versus Sethuraman has ended in a draw. The position was somehow around slightly better for white, but Sethu managed to fight on, and then in this rook endgame, yeah, this is a draw. I think it's still going on here, but most likely it should end in a draw. We had Gukesh winning his game against Kirill Georgiev, and Gukesh played a very solid opening. He didn't give really his opponent too many chances. Pushed his pawn to c4, knight c5, knight b3, and he got his pieces like this with knight coming to d3. It's already very difficult because the bishop is quite passive, and then knight f3 check was very strong. Take, take, queen c4, fg2, and and bishop takes h2 coming up now. Rook d2 and Gukesh beat Kirill Georgiev with a scintillating attack. Meanwhile, Surya Ganguly also has managed to get a winning position against Alexey Zverev. Here the position is round about even till now, but somehow Surya started to press and he managed to convert this into a pure bishop endgame, which was better for him. So Surya Ganguly beats Alexey Zverev. Adiban's woes in the tournament continue. He was unable to find anything much in his game against Meshkov. Yeah, and the players agreed to a draw. Although Adiban kept fighting, it was not enough. I think that is how all the games were in the open segment. Moving to the women's segment, Harika drew her game with Elizabeth Pates. Seemed like Harika was better but was unable to convert it here, and in the end players agreed to a draw when the pawns were getting exchanged. A big result for India was Vantika Agrawal beating Natalia Buxa, and the position was once again kind of equalish. Vantika had played a very nice Sicilian, but now this move b4 wasn't the best. D5, and this is now just winning. There was a very nice tactic in the position which I would like to show you, and you need to guess as to what is the best move here. So in this position, why couldn't white take on f7? This is a question for you. Try to think, because rook f7 is met with queen h2 and rook g2, and it's a checkmate. Rook g4, and now she took here. Rook g1, knight e5. Yeah, this was just simple. And Vantika's great performance continues. She is now has gained 40 elo points in this tournament, and she is closing in on the 2370 mark and also the IM norm she's got. Next up is Divya Deshmukh. Managed to win her game against Jessie February. She got her extra pawn out of the opening. She sacrificed a pawn, actually. Divya is white here, and then bishop b5. She even sacrificed an exchange, but this is all about Divya. She loves to attack. She got her pieces in, and that's how Divya hunted the king and finally checkmated her opponent. Padmini Rao has roughly an even position here, although like Padmini is two pawns up. It seems like this configuration is just a perfect for white to keep checking, and black does not have a way to get out of it, so it's a draw. And also Vaishali against Antoaneta Stefanova. Somehow the position was slightly different, but Stefanova was better pushing throughout the game, but Vaishali was very, very tenacious, and she managed to hold this to a draw. I mean, the game is still going on, but most likely this is going to end in a draw. It's a Philidor position. Shashi Kiran has a completely lost position right now. That would end any Indian's hope of making it to the candidates, but still the top 8 spots I feel are still open. So that was the roundup.